in the lab, doing stuff, making something.
Cleaner than it was last time. I've actually had a lot of time on my hands, so I've been cleaning. Yeah, and I've got something kind of special because those of you who watch my channel know that I love electronics kits, and I did a video just a little while back about my Mr. Wizard's experiments in electronics kit, which was my first electronics kit, and I'll put a link in the description to that one. And shortly after that, I guess, like, you know, I was probably like 12 or 13 years old when I got that, but the Mr. Wizard's kit was very kind of limiting what I could do, but it really sparked my interest. And so the very next thing I got, after like, you know, 6 months of really bugging my parents, that they got me one of these. This is the Science Fair 150-in-1 kit. This is not actually my original one. This is one that I got off eBay about 10 years ago. It's just like I could have one, but it's the same, exact same one that I did have when I was a kid, that I destroyed. I'm probably parted out later. But this is like the classic learning kit. These were sold in Radio Shacks. But this is really how I really began to learn electronics, by doing projects on the 150-in-1 kit. And I really have been pining a long time about, you know, you just can't get really great teaching tools like this and what you can get for kids and everything. But there is a new kit in town, and this is the Elenco 130-in-1 kit, and it has all the same benchmarks of the original kit. It's got the springy connectors and everything, and kind of the same basic kind of layout. And I really, really wanted to get into this. I haven't even opened it up yet, but I really wanted to get into this to really compare the new versus the vintage, and see what kind of projects they offer with this, and compare it to the projects in the 150-in-1 kit, and really see if this new kit really matches up for fun and also for value. And I'll compare that in a moment. But let's just get right into it and look at these close up. Okay, so here's the 150-in-1 kit, and like I said, this is not even my original one. This is one that I got off of eBay like around 10 years ago, just because I wanted to have one. I still have, though, my original book. I kept the book, so I got the original project book, and I've actually gone through this many times, you know, looking for cool circuits and stuff. The oscillators were always the coolest, in my opinion, of the sort of projects you could do with this kit. Lots of oscillators, sirens, beepers, you know, yeah. And the oscillators were a lot of fun, because you could wire up an oscillator and then you could bend it. And really, that's how I learned, you know, how electronics worked. And you could do all kinds of things, you know. Had light cells. I had like a photoresistor and a photo cell. And so you could do light sensitive stuff and light controlled stuff. Had a relay, so you could have a light controlled relays and switch stuff that was outside of the kit. You know, push pull square wave also. You could actually do pretty cool advanced stuff with the 150-in-1 kit. And, you know, that's why this is such a powerful learning tool and just so much fun, and so many hours that I spent putting together projects with 150-in-1. And one of the things about this particular one that I got off eBay, it still has the original price tag on it, $29.95, about 30 bucks. So, yeah, a Radio Shack sticker, it's official. So in like 77, 78, when this would have been new and in the stores, about 30 bucks. That's, I think for inflation, that translates into about $100 in 2020 dollars. So think of this as like a $100 kit, is what you would have spent the equivalent of back in the day. Not cheap, but, you certainly, very, very versatile kit, the 151. They did have smaller ones. I think they had the 130, 100, and 101, and they had like smaller versions. But this one was cool because it had, the digital display that was like totally cutting edge in 77. I remember doing so many projects where I would turn on a number. Now it doesn't have any like LED like counter drivers on this. You know, there's no way you can like have it count to 10. With this particular kit, there were just not enough components to do it discreetly, but you could have a transistor turn on the display, and you could hardwire up a number or a letter, like letter A or something, or 5 or an 8 or whatever, and have it turn on a number. It did have this integrated circuit, which is basically just, you know, 3 transistors put together for doing, you know, amplifier type projects and such. It had 2 PNP germanium transistors and a silicon NPN. It has 2 germanium diodes for doing radio stuff, and it has a silicon diode. It has a solar cell, which you could use to generate a small charge for controlling things and also to, you know, view like on the meter. It has a photo cell, you know, so you could do light controlled oscillators and such. It had a, you know, potentiometer. As an audio output transformer and a speaker for doing, like, say you could do oscillators that would run a speaker. It also had like a crystal earpiece for doing radio stuff, and the radio coils and tuner capacitor, switch, you know, so you could switch in and out things. Has bank of resistors, capacitors, a real relay, and a lamp you could turn on. You know, analog meter, and batteries, you know, a 3-volt with 2 AA's and a 9-volt. Of course, this is missing the clip from this USB, this one I got on eBay. But this is pretty much the kit that originally was what I learned on, 151 from the 1970s. So let's see how this compares to the Elenco. All right, here's the Elenco Electronic Playground 130, model EP130, fully assembled, 164-page manual, 130 exciting projects. So you can build an electronic siren, LED strobe light, light dimmer, sound amplifier, winking LEDs, sound machine, pencil lead organ, that's interesting, tone mixing amplifier, burglar alarm, first aid siren, voice activated LED logic tester, sound alarm circuit, voice level meter, delayed timer, AM radio station, conductivity tester, audio signal tracer, metal detector, water level alarm, requires 6 AA batteries, I guess no 9-volt in this, start a great hobby in electronics, no prior knowledge needed to assemble, spring coil connections, yep. All right, so I haven't even opened this up yet. Oh, okay. All right, nice packaging. Minimal packaging. Important, read this first. If you should encounter any problems or missing parts, do not return the retailer, call us. Okay. Wheeling, Illinois. Will do, if we have any problems. Oh, okay. Oh, look, they got the crystal ear piece. Yeah. Wires pre-cut, just like the other kit. Yep. All right, got some wires. Ooh, all right, got the manual, bent up. That's hardbound. It's actually a hardbound book. So, all right, it's got the schematics. That's what you want. Welcome to digital circuits. All right, it's got the LED display just like the 151 with the resistors built in. Exactly the same, yep. Flip-flopping light dimmer. This probably has like more versatility in like the digital stuff than my old 150 would. And the meowing cat, calling fish, like they have oscillators. Yeah, that's what you want, oscillators and stuff, metronome. So a lot of these, it looks like, you know, a lot of very similar type projects, although this has got like a logic chip in it, 7400 series logic chip. So this is gonna have a lot more in the digital stuff. Yep, alert siren. Yep, so these are pretty sophisticated with speakers and everything. Pretty good. Pulse frequency multiplier. Yeah, these actually are, these are much more advanced kinds of circuits than you'd have with the old science fair kit, certainly. All right, let's take a look here. All right. Very similar box. It's shrink in plastic. Okay. Okay, so first impressions, it's got two plastic sides. These are plastic, and this is cardboard, which again, that would go with the other kit. And it's got the battery compartments on the back side, cardboard all around, sealed here. Oh, looks like a manufacturing date, July 17. I've actually had this a while. I've been sitting on it for a couple years, so it was probably close to new when I bought it. It's got a transformer and a cool little plastic case. I dig that. That's really cool. Little enclosure. Got the speaker. Got the digital display. That's so classic, just like the 150-in-1 with the resistors built in, you know, current limiting resistors. And you know, very vintage-looking and very vintage-sized display, too. In fact, let me take a look at that display. So it's a newly manufactured, I think, date code of very much in the style of the 70s kits. Got a control with a really cool machined aluminum knob. Yeah, it feels pretty cool. Genuine aluminum machined knob. Got the taps here from the batteries in the back. Got 4.5 volt taps, 1.5 volt taps, and on the positive, and then the negative side, for both sides. Okay, gives you lots of voltage options. We got the radio stuff, we got the coils, and got the tuning capacitor. Again, that's just right out of the 150-in-1. Oh, we got the photo cell right there. Okay, just like the other one with a little shroud on it. I think the my original kit did have a shroud that you could remove too, but it's gone on my eBay kit. Oh, we got some LEDs. That's cool. With resistors, you could get the either take it direct or with the resistor. That's pretty well set up. 1, 2, 3 LEDs. All right, we got a 7400 quad 2 input NAND gate. That's pretty cool. And we've got a dual op amp. This is an NEC C358C dual op amp. We've got transistors. Got two PNPs. They're all silicon. And one MPN, that's the same arrangement as the 150-in-1, although these are all silicon in TO92 cases. Got some diodes, again, two germanium diodes and one silicon, and again, just like the 150-in-1. And got switches and a key. Ooh. It says key, but it's actually a button. But you got a push button switch there. We're doing Morse code, slider switch, and you got a bank of capacitors and resistors. Well, pretty much on par. I mean, you can put them side by side. Size-wise, here's the 150-in-1, here's the 130-in-1. A little more compact. I mean, it doesn't have the side compartment to store, but about the same size overall. But very much same. We got the radio stuff. The only thing this has that this doesn't, it's got the logic, this quad NAND gate, and this 150 has the solar cell, has a panel meter, and it has the relay. That's another thing that this 130 doesn't have, is the relay for switching, and of course this is the tungsten lamp, but Does have the same LED display. You can see it's, they really went and did the same LED display, you know, same size and everything. So this new kit has got pretty much everything that you would want, minus a few like classic details. And got all the wiring here, and yep, crystal earpiece, that's for the radio stuff, and yep, tinned wire. Yep, it's got some short wires, which comes in handy, and longer ones. Just a lot of green.
Okay.
So this is kind of like I guess you can cut and strip your own wire, but these are three green wires that are like a couple meters long, at least maybe 2 meters a piece. Okay, I don't know why you need that, but it's like kind of like 15 or so of these blue wires, which are kind of medium length. Okay, and shorter red wires, more of them. Again, maybe 20 or so. These shorter red wires. We got 5 kind of longish yellow wires.
Yeah.
They're going vintage with the tie wraps. and a couple of long black wires. So, and we got a bundle of short white wires. Okay, so let's take a look at the book, Electronic Playground and Learning Center, model EP130, Elenco in Wheeling, Illinois, copyright 2012-2009, so 2012 revised. Okay, so they've been making this for a while. I'm assuming that they're still making it. All right, basic table of contents. We got before we begin, installing the batteries, make the wire connections, we'll go through that. Playground of electronic circuits. See, oscillators, woodpecker, a police siren, grandfather clock, harp. So this is a lot of oscillator circuits. Basic electronic circuits, dimming light, flip-flopping, transistor action, transistor switching, sound amplifiers. That's pretty cool. LED display circuits, LED display basics, display with the photocell and the transistor. Okay. Switching LED display using transistor control, that's pretty cool. Flip-flop stuff, logic, fun with digital circuits, more logic. Really using that NAND gate chip. Meet transistor logic, all right, TTL stuff. LED buzz-in oscillators with TTL, one-shot, all right, so this is pretty cool. Oscillator application circuits, pencil-led organ, okay, using the carbon from a pencil-led. Adjustable RC oscillators, pulse alarms, yada yada. Meet the operational amplifiers. This is all audio stuff using the dual op amp, oscillators, sirens and such, Schmitt trigger, LED initials, wake up siren. Okay, more fun with operational amplifiers. So again, noise makers, sound alarms, cooking timer, RC delay timer, radio and communication circuits. Got an op amp AM radio, AM code transmitter, crystal set radio, 2-transistor radio, and Morse code oscillator with tone control. Test and measurement circuits, water level circuits, RF signal tracer, audio continuity tester, resistance tester, sine wave oscillator, twin T oscillator. So they got a pretty broad spectrum of projects. I would say that these are more, obviously, because they have the logic stuff, you know, maybe it's more challenging than in the vintage kit, which was much more into the discrete stuff. But let's see, before we begin, before we start the fun, installing the batteries, how to do little pinchy things with the springs. Overview of schematics. Okay. The antenna, speaker, All right. Crystal earpiece, switches, terminals, troubleshooting. All right. All right. Well, let's pick something and put it together. We'll try the very first project, because this is a very classic one, the woodpecker. A very classic kind of oscillator. So I'm going to grab some batteries. Loading up the batteries. I'm going to mix battery types, so it's going to drive people crazy. I'm going to mix them up. Let's see here. Alrighty, I'm going to be using the full 9 volts. We're going to use a transistor, PNP transistor, and I'm going to use the control pot, some resistors, 100 microfarad cap, 0.02 mic cap, 0.05 mic cap, and hook up to the audio transformer and hook up the speaker. That's what we're going to do. And you can read. For your first experiment, you are going to make a circuit that sounds like a woodpecker chirping. Follow the wiring sequence carefully and observe the drawings. Don't forget to make all the proper connections and have fun! Exclamation point! Have fun! The simple circuit shown here does not have a key or a switch, but you can easily add one. Replace connection 124-28 with connections 124-137 and 138-28 to connect the key. Go outside and see if you can track birds with it. That's kind of cool, yeah. Want a different sound? Try varied combinations of capacitance and resistance in place of the 100 microfarad capacitor and the 1K resistor. To change the 100 microfarad capacitor, it tells you how to do that. Your bird might sound like a cricket or a bear. Also, you can try using the 3-volt power supply. Disconnect terminal 119. Now your bird might sound like an English sparrow. Feel free to experiment. Just don't replace the 47K ohm resistor with anything below 10K ohms, because it might damage the transistor. All right. Interesting thing here is they're not telling you what, like, you know, the wires seem to be color-coded by length, but there's no instructions about this is going to be this color wire, that color wire. They just sort of allow you to kind of do it, you know, like with the wires you got. So, okay. Let me just wire it together as drawn. Looks like final connection. We hook up. Right. Whew. Yeah, that would drive me crazy. Okay, it works. Let's change the frequency. I'm gonna take out. Let's see here. Yeah. All right. So let's change out the 100 mic capacitor for the 470. See what that does. increase the capacitance. Oh, so that's much more realistic. Success. these really are a lot of fun. I think the only problem with these, I'm sorry, problem, but I remember as a kid, you know, once I'd tinkered together a working circuit, I wouldn't want to take it apart. You know, I'd play with it and it'd be together for days or weeks, and it's like I'd want to do something else, but I'd have to tear apart what I had spent time, you know, making. So Yeah. NOR transistor circuits, NAND DTL circuit with display. So yeah, a lot of these logic things. Flip flops. Of course, you got the quad NAND. So yeah, flip flops. Of course, it would be cool if it had a relay, because you know, when you got a flip flop and transistors, you know, if you have a relay, then you can build something on the board to make it turn on anything you want, you know. Of course, that probably makes it a little more dangerous, too, because you want to be turning on, like, lamps and stuff like that, and high voltage stuff. But that was, like, one of the... But I guess, you know, if you added the relay and maybe a meter, you know, even if it were a digital meter, it would probably be 151 kit. Have to be a step up. Here's the other thing about value. I paid for this kit, as I recall, I paid about $50. It might have been like $45 or something with tax. But it was around $50 retail. I actually bought this in a shop that had like educational toys. So I paid about $50 retail. So with inflation, this would be, you know, at least like half the price in today's dollars of what that Science Fair 151 kit was back in the day, would have cost, you know, in 1977 dollars, like almost twice as much. But yeah, I mean, this is pretty much, you know, what you would want in a project kit. So I'm very happy with this. The fact that it's made of cardboard, it's not a problem. I think that's actually, you know, keeping in the tradition very much of the original construction of the original Science Fair kits. The speaker punch-out is almost identical, you know. Even like the same kind of look and everything. It's even the same size speaker as the original kit. So this is, it's very fateful, I think, to the spirit and functionality, particularly with the springy connections of the original kits. So yeah, I'm very happy with this. Very happy indeed. Thumbs up. Good job, Elenco. That's it for this one. Thanks for watching. Thanks to all of my patrons down there on that Patreon, making all these videos possible. It's true. Would not be able to do any of this if it weren't for the rock solid support of my awesome patrons. And thank you, everyone who supports this channel on Patreon. If you liked this video, if you liked any of my videos, consider becoming a patron. That's how I continue to do this. Just follow the link in the description. Just go there, you can get all kinds of special stuff, sneak previews of all my videos and secret blog posts, stuff like that. So, some perks for those who support the channel on Patreon. Okay, that's it. I'm Fran. I'll be back here real soon. Bye! Berserk in my lab, it's where I work.
At the bench again.